language that they speak. They don't understand what fracking means or how it would affect them in the long run. How many of you right here know what fracking means? How many of you? Do fracking, I know, yeah, yeah, TD, Mihilis Bausen. Just two or three. I want to bring that out because the message that you guys are trying to put across, they have not understood what you're talking about. Mm. And you expect us to make a comment on it. When you talk Navajo versus English, you're still thinking in your own native tongue as to how to say it or to how to speak through it. And then you got to reinterpret that to the your language. And you want us to speak on it without having to really have the full understanding. So there needs to be a better way to get these people educated so that they can understand that. The leasing document that you talked about. Who decides what land is going to be leased out? And when? And are the people that are affected in their allotments, are they informed that their land has been let out, leased out, and then we're going to come and see you? The Nabataya Nadashta Ah, Nadashta Ah, Hai A Hut Ah, the Nabataya Ayeba Hinton, Hai A and No, Behawe Jis. Don't never care, I don't need that. The person that is there. Quite a good album, did it? Hi, you say, hey, come, some case that you need that. That's the question that I ask. Hey, who decides where the land's going to be leased out? And who starts? And who do they talk to in case their land is leased out? Is it BLM or is it BIA? And a lot of times, a lot of the leasing documents as far as the contract, they're not available. Even to this day, I don't think some of these people have those documents at all. Not so say, oh, I need it, not so say, I also know, me tell ya, me it's a, be kind or go be your best adult, yeah. Maybe they don't hit you, put that just either, but not only 1,000.